Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week, we'll learn some basic pike minnow fishing techniques so you can earn that cash. Then it's Columbia River Smallmouth. Now, if you want to learn how to catch more fish and make more money, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're near Beacon Rock on the Columbia River, a central location for the Northern Pike Minnow Sport Reward Program, which pays up to $8 per pike minnow turned in by everyday anglers to help protect native salmon and steelhead populations from pike minnow predation.
So before we start fishing, we need to fill out our registration form for the Sport Reward Fishery Program for the pike minnow.
All you need is your last name, first name, state zip code, phone number, and your fishing license number, which is your wild ID number with the state of Washington. Sign it, put today's date, put the actual day's date, even if you're fishing after hours and your registration time, AM or PM. If it's after 12:30, you're gonna be signing up for the same day, but turning in the next day at between 9:30 and 12:30. So you just put the same day's date that you're actually fishing.
So did you get your money yet for your tagged fish a couple weeks ago?
No, still waiting on the check in the mail. Got the check for the $5 fishes, but the tagged fish check hasn't come yet. It goes to a different place than the other regular vouchers go to. So this is a really worthwhile program. The other day I was out, you always hear about guys catching tagged fish. Hadn't seen one yet. Then I was throwing a Yamamoto grub and picked up a squawfish. It came in, covered with slime all over its back, and it was a tagged squawfish. And the tag was all covered with slime. And that's a $500 fish, and they release them all up and down the river. And a lot of times they pull up with ones that they've went with before. But for me, that's my first tagged fish. But $500 is $500.
So we can see just schools of little ones right here, up to like 6-7 inches long for the sport program here. Or the fishery program, they need to be 9 inches long to turn in. We're kind of here at the dock, just showing you that it doesn't necessarily, you don't necessarily need a boat. Yeah, we're standing in the boat, but we could just as easy be standing on the dock here. And we're right now, we're just bait fishing. We'll throw some lures here after a bit, but just getting started. We'll show you here that you can be at the docks or on the bank and still do pretty well on this program. That one's getting bit right there.
Yeah. So I didn't grab the rod right away, because a lot of times the squawfish, northern pike minnow, will come up and peck at it for a little while before they eat it. You really want to have several good bites in a row before you set the hook, and then give them a good set.
Getting a bite there. There he is. Oh, he came off. He was there though. And that was on a garlic-injected nightcrawler. So our setup here, we're just using just an egg sinker with a barrel swivel, about 2.5 foot a leader, to a number four, actually in this case a number six hook. So in this area here, there's a lot of small fish, and you'll be hurting yourself if you're using too big of a hook. So we're running half of a worm here. I like to kind of thread them on. You can use a bait threader, but since we're only using half a worm, I won't, but I like to thread that down to where he's about half exposed there, and the hook's in about halfway point of his body. Thread it on, and they won't rob your bait quite as easy that way. And then we're just injecting them full of, this morning, so far, it's garlic bloody tuna. So we'll just go into him. Shoot them up with a little bit. It'll actually, a lot of times you can give them a little bit of air and they'll also float also. So you can use that injector for both putting air in them and putting the scent inside of them. And this fishery, a lot of it will remind you of just trout fishing with your dad as a kid. It's awesome to take kids out and do this, and then they can make a little bit of money. You pay for all the gas, and they can have the money at the end of the day, or however you want to do it. It's kind of a neat program to do that on the weekends with kids, and they can earn a little bit extra money. That's what I did as a kid growing up. I spent one summer with my uncle and actually earned about $750 over a couple months just fishing with my uncle. So it's kind of a neat program to do with kids too.
Help preserve salmon and steelhead populations while earning money with the Northern Pike Minnow Sport Reward Program. Find all the information you need to get started at pikeminnow.org. Welcome back to the Columbia River. I'm Justin Wolf. It's a beautiful day for some pike minnow fishing, but while on some days pike minnow are easy to find and catch, Josh and Seth are finding out that today is not one of those days. But with a little luck, anyone with some simple equipment and bait can earn $5 to $8 per pike minnow.
There he is. Smallmouth.
One of the things about squaw fishing is, especially if you're fishing with worms, everything will eat a worm, and you get a lot of bycatch. So you get a lot of fish that you're not necessarily targeting. It does make it fun if you're out having fun doing this program. It probably gets frustrating to the guys that are doing it for a living, but you catch little guys like this. Nice little smallmouth. You get these little smallmouth, especially fishing worms. Little guys like that. They fight good. They actually fight better than a squaw fish. Mixes up your day and makes it fun. He ate the worm, or just lip hooked, but the worm fell in there, so I'm gonna let him have it. Off he'll go. So where we're fishing right now, we're in behind, in the kind of the slough that comes in behind Beacon Rock. And there's moving water. That's not crazy fast like the main river will be, but they like a little bit of moving water, some structure to it. This is all, you can see all the rock that's all through here. And any of these little current breaks they'll get in behind is evident on all the little guys that are hanging out here. You can see them as we look over the side. We can see quite a few fish. So
another bait that works really well for the pike minnow is fresh chicken livers. Keep them cold and it keeps them firm. Cut them up into some smaller pieces for the size of fish we're targeting today.
One of the nice things about the liver, fishing the liver versus a worm, is other fish don't seem to bother it quite as much. Every once in a while you'll catch channel cat or catfish also, which are kind of a neat bonus, but for the most part, you're gonna get squaw fish on the liver.
So liver is kind of a soft bait. Need to run it on a couple times, run it up the hook. Want the hook point exposed, and then several wraps with some ghost thread. Hold it on there. Got the hook point exposed and you're ready to fish. So we've been here for 15, 20 minutes. We've had a few bites, picked up one smallmouth bass, but if they haven't gotten worked up and really started biting by this point, maybe another 10 minutes, so a half hour, what we'll do is move on and start working the bank looking for fish, maybe throw some grubs, other things that they like to eat like that. But you don't just want to sit in one spot. If they're not there, they're not there. Squaw fish move up and down the river quite a bit. You want to move and go find them. So earlier today, before we got on film, we did pick up one larger squaw fish on the Yamamoto grubs with a chartreuse head. I really like eating those. A lot of times you catch pike minnow on these, as well as smallmouth bass. But this is the one we got earlier today. Pretty big fish. Went ahead and put him right on ice because for the reward program, a lot of times they use them. They have to be fresh on ice or alive, but they have to be kept cool to be turned in. So we put him on ice right away.
Real small lures, I like to run these smaller swivels. The nice thing about these power swivels that Spro makes, this size right here, which is a size 8, you see how tiny that little guy is. You see how tiny that is. That's a 50-pound swivel, which is like way more powerful, of course, than I need, but also way more powerful than what other swivels of the same size are. So the nice high-quality swivel is kind of nice to have, and they turn real freely still with 50 pounds of with being able to handle 50 pounds of pressure. So what I have rigged up here is a small gold Rattlemaster with, I'm just running 6 pound, about 18, 24 inches of leader.
So here we have a 5-inch Yamamoto grub on a chartreuse head, red hook. I like the extra bit of color. Squawfish, northern pike minnow, think it's a smolt. And a lot of times they'll have this 3/4 of the way down their mouth. Good soft plastic like this Yamamoto, they'll take right away. They ambush this grub just like the northern pike minnow do. You'll get a lot of these as bycatch. But like Josh said earlier, if you're fishing with your kids, they're a blast to catch, they fight hard. Sporty fish.
Help preserve salmon and steelhead populations while earning money with the Northern Pike Minnow Sport Reward Program. Find all the information you need to get started at pikeminnow.org. We've launched at the mouth of the Wind River, a Washington side tributary of the Columbia that's well known for salmon fishing, but also smallmouth bass.
So today mostly we'll be focusing on single-tail grubs, specifically these Yamamotos in the luminous white color. Those are the ones that have really been putting the fish on for me all summer. So launching here at the mouth of the Wind River, the channel always changes, kind of following the weed line right here and making our way out to the main channel between the bank and the island. If you do launch here to fish, you don't want to just get on plane and go shooting out. There's a channel, sometimes it's along the Highway 14, sometimes it's out from the launch, but almost everybody comes out on a kicker or on a bow mount or something. You can't just get on plane here at the mouth of the river and run straight out. Tail up.
Well, it's gonna be a nice day out here.
Yeah.
We worked inside of here. And
yeah. There's inside this part right here, there's fish, but I only fish it when it's windy. Otherwise, I go out to that side and then work down around past the island.
Hi. Good morning. How are you?
So today we're fishing for smallmouth bass, but everybody else, because the main stem of the Columbia is closed for salmon, everybody else is in here in what is technically the mouth of the Wind River, fishing for salmon here or at Drano Lake. They do pretty good.
What do they normally troll with?
Wigglewarts. See some guys with super baits every once in a while in the 360 degree flasher. A lot of times a small Hildebrandt spinner behind that. These smallmouth bass are delicious if you treat them right.
No, they're not, they're yucky.
Oh dude, they're so good. Seriously, if I cooked it for you, you'd be like, oh, okay. Once a year is all I keep them.
I've never eaten one.
Any bass ever?
Nope.
What? They're good.
Probably. Crappie and perch, walleye. That's
okay, so that P-line casts crazy good. That's my first time with CX.
So yeah, bass, never eaten one. I hear they taste like mud, but you say they taste pretty good?
Soak them in buttermilk for maybe an hour before you cook them, put them in the fridge, cover them over with buttermilk, make sure the skin's off the flay, any of the dark red or gray stuff on the skin side, fry them up like you'd fry any fish and they're delicious.
I'm gonna center the hook and the bait. I'm gonna try to get the hook to come out in the middle center on the bait, push it up to the head, and just kind of poke it a little bit through so it lays flat. And it's kind of weed guarded, the fish take it. As it falls, that tail with the going the way we did starts to curl and wiggle down as it falls. Sometimes you'll get the fish on the fall as you cast it in there.
So we're gonna be heading out more out of this bay into the main river where the fish are a little more concentrated, feeding on a lot of bait fish this time of year. Still quite a bit of crawfish, but mostly bait fish at this point. Oh, got bumped. Oh, just do it. Bite it. Come on.
Just kind of stay out, what, about 30, 40 feet from the bank?
This is just about right. Because especially where it's not weedy, every once in a while, they'll follow pretty consistently. I'll let it get back to the boat and drop to the bottom. I picked up quite a few fish doing that this summer.
I fished here for a tournament a few years ago and we caught some fish, but it's fairly new to me. New spots to learn. That's kind of exciting. You never know. Get back up here again and fish, but lots of good hiding spots for them. It looks fishy.
A lot of what we'll be fishing today is rocks. Basketball size, watermelon size. It's the kind of rocks you want to target. But also in the Columbia here, especially over on the Oregon side, there's weed lines that run with the current. And once the sun's up and we can see them, we'll get along those weed lines and fish lengthwise along them with the current. The smallmouth will be in there eating little bait fish and crawdads off of the rocks. It's a good place for them to hide when the sun's up. And when the sun's up, we can see that weed line and fish right along it. Oh, it's a fish.
Got him?
Oh, yeah, it's a little guy.
Need the net?
I don't think so. Just a pounder. Perfect. Smaller fish, half pounder, three quarter pounder. Great fighter, plenty of them to catch. Let him go back home. Everyday fishing, you'd expect to catch several in the pound to 2 pound range, and on a good day, maybe, you know, 4 or 5 in the 3 pound range. Most of your fish are gonna be smaller fish, but being smallmouth, they like to fight real hard. And even the smaller fish give up a sporty fight.
Welcome back to the Columbia River. I'm Justin Wolf. Phil Martin and Seth Teeters are starting to have some luck with hard-fighting smallmouth bass on Yamamoto single-tail grubs.
Pound for pound, they fight as hard as a steelhead.
Yeah. You got a 10-pound smallmouth bass, you're gonna fight as hard as a 10-pound steelhead. Not a popular sentiment in the Northwest, but.
But what a great thing for kids. I mean,
oh, right.
You'll catch, you know, 30, 40 in a day or more, right, depending.
Yeah, the first day I had the girls here, they, you know, we rounded that point and we had 3 doubles by the time we got to this point for the kids. It was right after a bit, there's a fish.
Yep. A bad little guy.
He spat out some fish.
It's almost like a green color once it gets in the water. It's a glow in the dark. So I think it just adds that neon green, something different. I know when we fished up here, we did some of the Yamamotos in the 176 and did really well. But just a 1/4 ounce, 3/8 ounce jig head.
Yeah. That's almost all I ever fish anymore is a 1/4 ounce round ball. These chartreuse. I think it goes nicely with that green color of this grub. So I usually like to make sure I sign up for the Pike Minnow program on days when I'm out here smallmouth fishing, because they bite the same thing smallmouth bite. A lot of the time, other than crawfish, they're eating the same thing that smallmouth are eating, small bait fish. And while I was bass fishing this year, on one of these Yamamoto grubs, I had signed up previously and went out bass fishing in the evening and caught a tagged squawfish, which was worth $500. So it's always beneficial because you never know when you're gonna catch one. Almost every time I go bass fishing, I catch one or two.
Helps pay for the gas.
Yeah. Every once in a while, when the fish aren't biting too hard, I'll just take one of the stronger Procure scents, Anna's Bloody Tuna or something like that, put a little bit on the collar, give a little added scent trail.
Pulling hard.
Yeah. Oh, he's not
that
big.
Scrapper though.
He's scrapping. But he's a good fish.
That's a decent fish.
Yeah. Probably 2.5 pounds. That fish followed it for 20 feet. I felt him pecking at the back of the tail. So I slowed down my retrieve, dropped it down to the bottom and lifted up. And there he was, hooked right in the beak with that Yamamoto single tail grub. He's good jump. There you go. Hard fighters.
Not a bad fish.
Oh, nice pounder. Oh, there we go. Clean release.
Coming up, he's just spitting out a little tiny fry. Is like, I can see why those white baits, because that's the color
yep,
of the fry were.
Those white.
Hungry little guys.
Yeah, nope. They're voracious.
That was a quick release. There's one. Yeah, spitting up more fry.
Ooh. Good job. There's one.
Looks like a fairly decent one.
Decent.
Yeah.
Oh, spitting minnows. Yamamoto grub on there. This one's a 5-inch instead of 4-inch. Bite kind of slowed up on the luminous white. And this one is purple flake, I believe. Kind of a clear grub. Doesn't hurt to switch it up when the bite slows down.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.